it's time to pay.
Hey, Bert.
Yeah, man?
You see the way Kelly's poster's next to mine? It kind of spoils the whole effect. Why don't you take it down?
I can't do that, Matt.
You heard him. Take it down. Tear it up. All right, about this election. It's pretty important. Mm-hmm. And you know who to vote for, right?
You, Matt.
I'd say that was an extremely intelligent decision. Okay, kid, take off.
Come on. You heard him. Get going. I sure showed him, Matt. How'd I do?
Pretty good. Okay, let's get to class.
Is Mr. Burnett in?
What do you want to talk to him about?
About something that happened this morning outside.
Does Matt know about this?
Just forget about it. It wasn't important anyhow.
Today we're going to start a new assignment. I think it should be right up your alley. We're going to be doing vlogging.
What the heck is vlogging?
That's a good question. Vlogging is just like blogging, you know, a web diary that you might keep, only this is done with video. Think of it like Snapchat, only longer. And what you can use, you know, you guys all have smartphones, you can use smartphones, or you can use video cameras, and I want you to do it every day for the next 2 weeks. And really, just tell it the same thing that you would tell a diary. And at the end of 2 weeks, I'll check them and review them.
Mr. Schaefer, I don't keep a diary, and I wouldn't know what to tell one.
Okay, well that's a good point. What you can do, you can get online and check examples that are there, but don't feel like you're limited to that, okay? The important thing is to have fun with it, and then I'll review it, okay? Alright, so let's move on to more important things. We are on page 109 in your literature books, and that's Damon and Pythias.
Hey man, what do you think of this assignment?
It's alright. Schaefer's cool.
Can you help me with my vlog?
Sure, Cricket.
Thanks.
So Matt, how do you feel about the elections coming up?
Pretty solid, I have a good feeling.
I'll be voting for you.
Thanks.
You wouldn't have any idea who tore my poster now, would you, Matt?
What do you mean?
I think you know what I mean, man.
Now look, why would I want to go do something like that?
That's something only you would know.
Hey, Matt, who's the chick?
I think that's the new girl.
That's nice, isn't it?
Sure it is.
Listen, fix me up, will you?
Yeah, no problem.
Class, this is Wanda. She's going to be switching into our hour for the rest of the semester. Okay? Let's see. Denise, can you get her caught up on the vlog assignment?
Sure, Mr. Schaefer.
Denise, right over there.
go on,
ask him. Now?
Now's as good a time as any.
Oh, hi, Bob.
Hi. Listen, I was wondering, are you doing anything this afternoon? The election, you'll probably be there. That's nice. I'll probably see you there.
Okay.
Why didn't you ask her? Man, I don't know. Maybe she doesn't want to go with me.
Well, you'll never know if you don't ask her.
I guess you're right.
Why don't you watch where you're going?
You're a little clumsy today, Lita.
Don't pay much attention to her. She's kind of funny.
Funny ha-ha, but funny strange.
Where are you from?
Portland.
Well, I'm Matt Stevens, and this is Cricket. If you're ready to go, we'll walk out with you.
Okay.
You. Now, if you don't get on the ball and move in pretty soon, somebody else will.
I know, but what am I going to say to her?
I don't know. Ask her to the movies tomorrow night. I mean, what am I supposed to do? Ask her for you?
You know, Kelly, I'll do it myself. You know what? I'll see you after class.
All right, hey, but are you going to vote for me?
Well, yeah, I don't want to see Matt as student body president.
Now you listen to me. I've got better things to do than deal with your little bits of temper. You pull another star like that, honey, you've had it. Got that? Now I want you to line Cricket up with that new girl, Wanda.
Who?
Wanda, the new girl. Tell her we'll meet her at the wagon at 8.
That's what I like about you, honey. You know what you want and you go after it. I'll see you later.
See you later.
So yeah. My name is Homer Gibson, but people call me Cricket, and, oh yeah, this is my first video blog. I really think this assignment is ridiculous. I don't know what to say to this camera. Matt said he would help me, but he's busy right now. Hey, Mr. Schaefer.
Okay. What's the matter, Cricket?
Yeah, I don't know what to say.
Well, just anything that's on your mind. You know, what's going on in Cricket's world right now?
Well, I want to be student body treasurer. I want people to think of me as a responsible person.
Okay, well, that's a start. Why do you want to be treasurer?
I just want people to respect me.
Okay, there you go. You can blog about that.
But that's all it is. That's all I have to say.
Well, that's a start, you know. And just, you know, go from there. Just take it from there. You'll be fine. Just open up. Good luck, Cricket.
So here I am, making my first video blog entry. Mr. Schaefer, our communications teacher, said to just say whatever's on our minds, so here goes. My name is Wanda Anderson, and I just moved here from Portland. It's been a big change since this is such a small town. The people here are really nice, though, mostly. I've made several new friends, and all of my teachers are really nice. I like my new house, and I like my classes. I guess that's all I can think of right now. Mr. Schaefer says we don't always have to vlog in this room. We can use our phones or whatever, just whenever the mood strikes. See ya.
Hello, Wilson High School. It's Matt Stevens' first vlog, and I know it's just what you've been waiting for. You guys can't get enough of me on Instagram, on Twitter, so here I am in all my glory. So we're supposed to talk about what's on our mind, and what's on my mind? It's the student body president elections. The guy I'm going against, Kelly Roberts, he's a good guy, but what Matt wants, Matt gets. Simple as that, okay? Yeah. So, a little about myself. I live in this big,
big white house and drive this cool, awesome car. Okay. And then I have like a ton of friends. Yeah. And I'm smoking hot. See them guns? Yeah. My folks are executives, so they're not in town that much. But so I mostly have the house to myself, except for the help. But they don't bother me. They mostly leave me alone. Anyway, Matt Stevens.
I'll tell you what's on my mind. Matt Stevens is a bully and I'm getting pretty sick of it. If he didn't have Cricket and his goons around him all the time, then I'd have a chance. How about that, Mr. Schaefer? Welcome to Wilson High.
Hey, what are you up to?
Oh, just hanging with the girls.
You sure about that?
Don't just stand there. Ask a girl to dance.
You want to dance?
Yeah, sure. I'd like to.
Honestly, that guy.
You're right.
What are you doing?
I'm lining them out first. They're easier to count that way.
Kelly, Matt, Kelly, Kelly, Matt.
Leda, I'm going into my office to finish off this paperwork. Let me know as soon as the ballots are counted, please.
Certainly, Mr. Burnett.
Thank you.
How's it going?
Fine.
I'll go get the rest of the ballots. Everyone should have voted by now.
Hey, what's the big idea?
You better keep your big mouth shut.
I'm following you, Marty. It's a new copy of this.
Is everything okay in here, Freddy?
Just fine. We'll be done here in a minute.
Okay.
That's it?
Okay. Thanks.
Looks like we have a winner.
So, are you doing anything tomorrow night?
No.
Would you want to go to a movie with me?
Yeah, I'd love that.
Oh, really?
Your attention, please. As the principal of Wilson High School, it's my honor to announce that you've elected as your student body treasurer, Homer Davis.
Who's Homer?
Better known to you as Cricket. And for student body president, Matthew Stevens.
Next time, Kelly.
Thanks, Matt.
So here's my first vlog. What are you supposed to do when you're forced to do something wrong? I knew Matt had a lot of friends. Slick and Hawk have certainly pushed me around enough. But those kids today in the ballot room? I didn't know they were on Matt's goon squad. And who am I going to tell? Mr. Burnett? Who am I kidding? I can't make a journal like this. What if Matt got a hold of it?
Delete.
I sure wish the election hadn't turned out the way it did.
I was counting on being the right-hand man to the president.
I think that's the way it goes. You guys ready for the races Saturday?
Ready and rock and roll.
I guess the only thing Matt hasn't taken over now is our drag races.
Are they dangerous?
No, not really. We just do it for the fun of it. I don't know of anybody that wants to win so bad that they get killed over it.
Got that right.
Hey, do the rest of the fellas know about it?
Yeah, Rod and I will spread the word this afternoon.
All right, let's keep it quiet though. We don't want Stevens warning in on this.
Interruption. I would just like to thank everyone for voting for me and for electing me student body president. A quick little announcement. Since the dance went over so well today, we are going to start having one every Friday starting tomorrow.
Yeah!
There will be a $2 admission fee, which will go towards the fund for a new school mascot.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And now, a round of Dr. Pepper for everyone, and it's on me.
Hey, make a note of the tab. We'll get it all back.
Yeah, you bet.
Gee, I think a mascot sounds like a great idea.
Well, you can bet there's a catch to it if Matt has anything to do with it.
Well, gang, I've got to go. I've got to cram for an exam tomorrow, and if I don't, I'll be a senior for the rest of my natural life.
Yeah, you're not the only one.
Let's shag out of here.
I can't. I've got to go meet Annie. We're filming stuff for drama class.
Okay, I'll text you later.
Wanda, can I take you home?
Sure, Bob.
Kelly, it's the rush. Got a free Dr. Pepper waiting on you.
Thanks, Matt, but I can still afford my own.
Hey Matt, when are you gonna fix me up with Wanda?
Tomorrow night, alright?
You sure?
Yes. Relax about it.
As we all know, a gentleman endowed with good fortune must be in want of a wife. I'm Lizzie Bennett.
And I'm Charlotte Lou.
And these are the Lizzie Bennett Diaries. Dun, 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 dun. I wish. For those of you who don't know about the Lizzie Bennett Diaries, have you been living in a box? A box without the internet? A box without YouTube? As much as we wish we were Lizzie and Charlotte, this is actually the first installment of our video project for our Drama 2 class. I'm Annie. And I'm Penny. And this is our history film project on a movie that was made in our town in 1959 called High School Caesar. Most of the time, I'll be behind the camera because my filming and editing skills far outshine those of my research partner. Yeah, well, that means I'm the one more gifted in communication. Whatevs. Anyway, everyone in our Drama 2 class was assigned some sort of history film project, and our project is to investigate everything we know about High School Caesar. We're going to learn as much about it as we can and then share it with you. The first thing you need to do, though, is to watch High School Caesar. It's on YouTube. But it's in black and white, so don't be scared. Don't have time to watch? That's okay. We'll show you all the clips that you need to see, like this epic dance scene. Well, that's the end of today's installment. Annie and Penny, out.
morning, Lucy.
My goodness, you are in a good mood this morning.
Well, why shouldn't I be? I have the best cook in the whole world.
Now you go on. Eat your breakfast before it gets cold.
Oh, all right. Hey, how about some music?
What do you want to hear?
You know what I like. You pick it out. And send Carter in, will you please?
Yes, Matthew.
You want to see me, sir?
Is the car ready?
Yes, sir.
Washed?
Yes, sir.
I just want to remind you, Carter, that if I find the car like I did yesterday, I don't intend on driving it.
No, sir. Yes, sir.
And one more thing. If you can't perform your duties up to my satisfaction, I'll just find someone to replace you.
Yes, sir. Is that all?
That's all.
Is something wrong with your breakfast, Matthew?
No. Just not hungry.
Did you text your folks that you are president of the student body?
Why should I? It's not like they care.
Now, Matthew.
Now, listen, Lucy, I gotta run. You know, you're getting prettier every single day. I'm just waiting for the day one of your boyfriends is up and taking you for good.
Now you go on.
I'll see you later.
Day 2 of the vlogging assignment.
I should be really happy, you know. I won student body president. But I miss my parents. I doubt they miss me. I never hear from them. I text every once in a while. My dad gave me this coin a few years ago to bring me good luck. But what do I have to get to bring me parents?
Seems like that boy's folks ought to just stay home instead of gallivanting all over Europe and places like that.
Well, I don't blame them. If I had a brat like that, I'd take off too.
You just don't understand, Matthew.
Ah, I've got him pegged all right.
Hey, Wanda. I'm Lita, Matt's steady. I just wanted to tell you that you're Cricket's girl now, and you're going to meet him tonight at the hangout at 8 o'clock. See ya. Hey, what's the big idea? Nobody tells me who I've got a date with. You better watch your step. Those are orders from Matt. You listen to me. You or nobody else is going to tell me what to do. So you can just tell your Mr. Matt Stevens to drop dead. The nerve of some people. I take back what I said about all the kids in this school being friendly. Some of them are actually really mean. Like, is that Lita girl being serious? You better watch your step. Who even says that? I feel like I'm in some gangster movie.
Lita and I this weekend, we...
Hey, Matt.
Now knock that off. Make it look like a normal conversation or I won't bother with you.
I need an English lit test. I didn't have time to study over the weekend.
I don't care if you had time to study or not. Give Cricket $80 and he'll have it to you by Monday.
$80?
Take it or leave it.
I don't think I can raise that much. Can I pay you part now and part later?
I'm running a business, not a charity organization. Now, no money, no test.
Okay.
Make arrangements with Cricket.
All right, I'll do it.
Okay, go. All
right, Matt.
Matt.
I know.
How's the president this morning?
Good, baby. You talked to Wanda yet?
Yeah, I just saw her. Everything's all set for tonight.
That's my girl.
Pretty good, man. I'd say about $150.
All right, sweet. Okay. Go ahead, take 40. Not now. Take some of the small bills.
You took the big ones, it'll look too funny. You see, student body treasurer, you're gonna be very, very important to me.
Matt, I thought you fixed a bit with Juan.
Now don't point. Relax. Everything's under control. Wanda set it up. She's meeting you at the wagon at 8.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Oh, hi, Chowd. Mr. Burnett.
Hello, Homer. How's the mascot money coming?
Just fine. I'd say about $100.
Well?
That count in again, make sure.
Well, at that rate, it won't take long to get that mascot money. Hey, if you see Matthew, would you have him stop by my office?
Okay, I'll talk to him.
Thank you.
Hey, Matt. Old Chowderhead wants to go see you. What do you think is wrong?
Relax, all right? Probably just wants my advice on something.
But he looked funny.
I'll see what it is. You stay here. Cricket said you wanted to see me, sir?
Yes, sit down, would you, Matthew? Matthew, there's a potentially serious problem going on at the school. Damage to personal property, kids getting roughed up, things like that. Have you heard anything about it?
Well, not directly. I mean, I've been walking on the calls and I've heard kids talking about it, but I didn't think it was that big of a deal.
I believe it is. As president of the student body, you might be able to help me.
Well, sir, what do you want me to do?
As a student, it'd be a lot easier for you to find information than it would be for me. I need to have you help me find that information.
I see. Well, I'll go around and I'll see what I can find out, and if you hear anything, I'll get back to you.
Thanks, Matt. I knew I could count on you.
You certainly can, sir. Is there anything else?
That's all. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
So here's what's on my mind today. Math. The Friday dance is going on in the commons, and there's at least 100 people in there. Now, admission is $2, but I just overheard Cricket tell Mr. Barnett that we only made about $100. Doesn't that seem like crazy math to you? Where's all the money going?
So the dance went really well this afternoon.
Can I see the money again?
You've seen $600 before. You don't need to see it again.
I know I've seen it, but it's just so pretty.
Look, you're fine. We got a lot going for us now. You got the dance on Friday, you got my protection insurance, and my file of tests.
Boy, you've got Chowderhead eating right out of your hand. I don't know how you do it.
Like this. Do you want a couple bucks for your date? And then you can come pick up your 10% tomorrow night?
Could I, Matt? Then I could show Wanda a really good time.
Sure. Listen now. How much are you gonna make this week?
Let's see. 10% of 600 is, I got lost.
Cricket, you're gonna have to learn to use that head of yours before somebody cheats you out of it, okay? Now, it's for your date, and you can take the Jeep.
Wow, Matt, thanks. This is gonna make the date amazing. I'll see you at the wagon tonight.
Carter? Lucy? Are you guys here?
Project. Today, a walk down memory lane. You should tell them where we are. We're at the site of the old high school, where much of High School Caesar was filmed. The building was built in 1924 and razed in 2009, but it was state-of-the-art in the spring of 1959 when High School Caesar was filmed. And through the magic of digital editing, here we are in Chula, at the building that was once called the Silver Spur. This building was used for the inside and outside shots of the wagon. Observe. We could go inside, but it doesn't look the same as it did in 1959, and we want to preserve the magic. Speaking of magic, here we are on Elmdale Road, the location of many residential scenes in and out. Once again, here it is in 1959. In 1959, this house was home to Bert Clark. Currently, this house is home to Douglas and Diana Roberts. That concludes our locations tour. Annie and Penny, out. I stay out too late. Got nothing in my brain. That's what people say. Mm-hmm. That's what people say. Mm-hmm. I go on too many dates.
Hey, scoot over. I made these reservations.
Hey, what picture are we going to see tonight?
I want to see the one at the Strand.
Yeah, so do I.
Something wrong?
No.
Would you like to dance?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Hey, you're gonna wear her out.
Not this kid.
Are you guys going to dance?
Nah.
Alright.
You fixed me up with Wanda.
That's right, buddy.
Well, she's in there with Bob.
Well, don't look at me.
Come on, we'll see about this.
What do you want, Matt?
You better take off, sister. Your date is waiting for you.
She's with her date.
Shut up! Now look.
Now look yourself. I don't know what goes on in this town, but I don't want any part of it. I happen to be with my date, Mr. Stevens, and not you or anyone else is gonna tell me what to do.
I told Cricket.
And I don't take orders from anybody, especially not from a pampered little punk like you.
Really?
There'll be no fighting in my place. If you guys have something to settle, you need to settle it outside.
Okay, big man! Let's go!
Come on, buddy, let's get out of here. We'll settle this later, Mr. Williams. What are you looking at? Dance! I said dance!
Yeah.
Greetings, it's Annie, here this morning with Mr. Otis Ireland, the brother of the writer and director of High School Caesar, Mr. O'Dale Ireland. Thank you for being with us this morning. Tell us about your and Mr. O'Dale's childhood.
Well, we was raised in Chula, just back in hard times. The house we lived in never even had electricity or running water in it. My father passed away in 1939. I was the oldest one of six children. I went into the Navy in December of 44. Then I got out in February of 46.
How did O'Dale get into movie making?
Well, he was in the Navy, and he was an aerophotographer on an aircraft carrier, and he had film. He told me about all of the countries of China, from a plane. And when he came back, he got involved in making movies.
Were you involved with High School Caesar?
No, I wasn't involved with it, no.
What other movie projects did O'Dale do?
None that I know of.
And can you tell us about O'Dale's life after movies?
He moved to California, and then after he moved out there, he started in making this movie. And he came back here, rounded up several of the high school kids and got them involved in the movie. But he brought back people from California too.
From in front of the Ireland Advertising and Electric Building, Annie and Penny out.
Hey Snapchat, this is Chillicothe123 just letting you know that I am super pumped to win the race this Saturday. And if it's one of my competitors watching this, good luck because you're going to need it.
Good luck, Rod.
You too, man.
Anybody want to bet on a winner?
Sure, what's the hot tip?
Me.
Oh, really, Bob?
Hey, the guy down at the auto shop said she'd be a sure winner because he put a new compressor on her.
You're going to spend a fortune on that bomb if you listen to those guys.
I guess we'll just wait and see if it's worth it.
Hey, where's B?
She's babysitting. I'm going to pick her up after the races. So, let's get ready for the first race.
Let's go!
How's it going, Bob?
Thank you.
Hey, nice job, man.
Thank you.
Hey, look, there's Stevens. Oh. He would have to come.
Hey, get out of here. It's private property.
Hey, we do what we want.
Yeah.
You don't own anything.
You can be around.
Hey, special?
Yeah. Yeah.
Why can't you come here?
Oh, yeah.
Come on.
All right, this is how it's going to be. For this next race, it's going to be a $10 entry fee. Okay?
Now, just a minute, Stevens. Nobody asked you to come out here. We were doing fine by ourselves. We're not paying any entry fee to you or anybody else.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not paying either.
I didn't think you would. All right, now wait just a minute. It's going to be a little different this time. When there's prize money, you got to have an entry fee. Now, I'm placing this gold coin as first place prize, okay? It's worth $500 or more. I don't know. You've all seen it, okay? And now, if you want this or want a chance of getting this, line up in front of Cricket and pay him the $10.
We cannot run in one race.
Why not?
Because it's dangerous. Why don't we just run two or three cars at a time and clock out the winner?
No, we'll run them all at once. Now, if you don't have the stomach for it, then you just don't enter.
Hey, who's gonna hold the prize money? When I win this race, I wanna make sure I get it.
I'll hold it.
All right, but I'll be back to pick it up. It's pretty important to me. Dad gave it to me.
Matt, you shouldn't have put your coin in.
Would you relax? They don't have a chance against that car, and you know that. Now go give the money to Wanda. Look at that. Hey, Stevens, next time you got something to give away, why don't you let me know?
Hey, congratulations, Kelly.
Let's knock it off for today.
I wish B would have been here to see it.
Yeah, me too.
Say, who has the sack of entry fees?
I don't have them. I think they're on the other end of the strip.
Do you need any help?
No, I'll go get it. I'll grab the sack, I'll get B, and I'll meet you guys at the hangout. Sound good?
Yeah, let's get out of here. Come on.
Good.
He's dead.
You shouldn't have done it, Matt. You shouldn't have done it.
What do you mean, me? You saw the tire blow out. It was an accident. Look, Cricket. This was my dad's good luck piece. Okay? Sure didn't cut Kelly any.
You're not gonna take it with you, are you, Matt?
Look, we're in this thing together. You got that? Okay? Nobody's gonna believe us. We're not gonna say a word about it, okay? We're not gonna say a single word, okay? We're gonna keep quiet. We're not gonna tell anyone. It was an accident, okay?
Yeah, Matt. Sure.
Hey, B, where's Kelly?
I don't
know. I thought he was with you.
We haven't seen him since the race. He said he was going to stop and pick you up.
He probably had some trouble with that bomb of his.
That's true. That thing is so darn temperamental.
He's probably sitting somewhere cussing up a storm. We should go look for him.
Hey, are you guys there? We need to talk. Call me as soon as you can. Carter! Is there an email?
Yes, sir, your check arrived today. Now loops there on the table.
Is there a letter?
A letter?
Something else?
A letter, no, sir.
Hi, Darlene. It's Matt Stevens. I've been trying to reach my dad. No. I got the mail, or I got the check. It's not that. Don't you know when he's coming back? Switzerland. Yeah, he's always gone. No, that's all right. Just forget it. Goodbye. Carter!
Yes, sir.
I noticed some dents in my ride. I want you to take it down and have them fixed.
Yes, sir. I'll do it first thing in the morning.
No, you'll do it now.
Now, sir? I don't understand.
You don't have to understand. Just do it now.
Yes, sir.
It's Kelly. He's had a wreck.
So, here's my video blog for today. Last time, I didn't know what to say. Today, I don't know how to say it. The race today, Kelly, Matt.
Greetings, it's Annie
and Penny.
And this is our fourth installment in our drama video research project. Today, we interview cast members who are in High School Caesar.
Thank you guys for being here. Tell us about how you were cast in the movie.
Speech class. Mr. Dow had speech class, and I think that's where I got chosen. Isn't that where you all were chosen from, too? Yeah.
The fictional Wilson High School from the movie seemed like a great place to go to school, except for the thugs. What was Chillicothe High School like in 1959 to 1960?
It was a great place to go to high school. It was very inclusive, and anybody who wanted to participate could participate if they put forth the effort. And we did lots of plays under the direction of Miss Wall. I am very thankful that I grew up in Chillicothe and went to Chillicothe High School.
Tell us what you did for fun.
There was a teenage hangout below the state bank called the Rumpus Room.
Yeah, I worked part-time at Clark's Drugstore. I was a soda jerk. And then I was not allowed to go to the Rumpus Room. I was the oldest of three girls, and my father was very strict, so I didn't get to go to the Rumpus Room.
Well, I worked. I was in the COE program where you went to school half a day and worked half a day. And back then, unlike now, there was no fast food places. So you worked in grocery stores back then. So I worked in a grocery store until I graduated, and then I went into service.
What aspects of High School Caesar ring true about your high school experience?
I don't know that much of what was in High School Caesar. We did as high school kids. We had to wear it. We wore our own clothes. And I didn't realize till I looked back at the movie that everything I wore was a sweater with a sailor collar on it. So
I had the black leather jacket and the ducktail, like Elvis had.
Matt Stevens, the main character, was clearly a bully. What would have happened to a bully in 1959?
Mr. Newbolt would have had him in the office, and he would have only been a bully for a day.
With a paddle with the holes in
it. That's right.
High School Caesar is supposed to take place over the course of 4 days. How long did it actually take to film?
2 weeks. We used to be on set at 4, between 4 and 4:30, and get off sometimes at, midnight, depending on what we were doing.
The scene I shot at the Strand Hotel took all afternoon to shoot, and it was lasted under 5 minutes in the movie.
What was the filming session like?
Well, the director telling you what to do. You had to memorize your lines, and you'd get your makeup put on, which was always a chore. Do what we were told to do.
How many students were involved in the film?
I'd have to guess 50, you think?
Two of us. Filming, speaking, and dancing scenes.
Right.
There was a lot in it that didn't have speaking parts.
Tell us about the roles you played.
My role has no name. I had a boyfriend in the movie who is played by my grandson, which is rather called my daughter. She thought that was kind of weird. He came from Kansas City. His name was Kirk Workman. I remember that. He was real tall, good looking, wore makeup all the time, which I never could understand that. But basically, we just played teenagers, just the kind of kids that they had picked.
Were you paid anything for being in the movie?
$90 for 2 weeks' work.
I was paid $95 for 2 weeks' work.
I got $200. I don't know why, but I did.
I don't know either.
Holy cow.
We need to protest that.
Yeah. Tell us more about the role that you played.
My name was Don in the movie, and of course, I was, like I said, the black leather jacket and all that. My scene, John Ashley was sitting behind the desk. And I come up to him and said, "What do you need, Don?" And I said, "Well, I need the answers to an upcoming science test I got." So you paid him, and he would have his thugs go out and break into the high school and get the answers to the test for you.
And my name was Bee, and my boyfriend's name was Kelly, and he was the handsome one from Hollywood. And, you know, we just did what teenagers do.
Did you keep any mementos from the film?
Well, apparently not enough since we can't find our scripts. That...
Well, I have the pictures that were on the windows of the Bimbo Theater. I came back for the showing in October, I remember. I was a freshman in college, but I came back. And so I have incorporated those in an album that I put together with all my pictures from Chillicothe.
Do you feel like making this movie was a part of making history, leaving a legacy?
You know, I didn't until the gentleman from UMKC came and presented that program on why it was made. Apparently they made movies for a general audience, and this was the first movie that was made for a specific audience, just teenagers, which is why he felt that it was important. There were three major films in the 50s that really identified the 50s, and this is one of them.
And I think that's why it's lasted as long as it has. And the most interesting thing to me is that it just keeps popping up in places that I didn't expect it.
I think it's a great movie to be made locally. It was a very well-made movie.
You know, I just remember not thinking it was that big a deal.
Yeah, that
it was fun.
It was just
fun.
An experience.
It was a lot of fun stuff.
And
I don't watch a movie the same anymore, do you? I can
right.
pick out mistakes in the movies, and I see shadows that aren't supposed to be there.
Would you do it again?
Yes. If I was a high school student and do it again? Or would I do it now?
Like, would you be in any kind of movie?
Now? Probably not.
I would.
Why not?
I think my daughter-in-law is going to play my part just fine, thank you.
And I'd do it again back then in a heartbeat, too.
It was
probably the first one to held my hand up when they asked. It was fun. I tell you, the 50s was the best years to grow up.
It was.
They really were.
Was it because we grew up in the 50s, or was it because we grew up in Chillicothe? And I think we've all kind of concluded that it was a combination of both of them.
Okay, what's wrong?
Matt, did you hear about Kelly?
Yeah, I heard about it.
Funny accident, huh?
Now, what's that crack supposed to mean?
I mean, I heard you were pretty mad about losing the coin.
Sure I was, because I thought I could win it back. That doesn't make any difference. I can always buy another one. Let's get the meeting started. Now, any of you who want a test or a paper need to see me after the meeting, because from now on, you're welcome to my finals for free. Okay, outsiders still need to pay $50 to $100, you know? We've been pretty lenient on this, and from now on, if they don't pay up front, then we're gonna work them over good.
Okay?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, now there's dancing and drinks in the other room. Meeting dismissed.
Hey, Matt.
Jonna, what can I do for you?
I need a biology test.
Is that from the new instructor?
Yeah.
When's the test?
Monday at 10:30.
Hawk, go get Lita. Jonna, go ahead and go to the party, but check with me before the night's over.
Thanks, Matt.
No problem.
I'd like an English 1 test, Matt.
English 1? One sec. That's it, isn't it?
Yeah, thanks.
Mm-hmm.
You wanted to see me, Matt?
Yeah, hi. Did you run off any new biology tests this week?
Yeah, I just finished them yesterday.
Okay, thank you. Alright, payday. Now, there's something extra in there for something you're going to have to do. Slick, Hawk, stick around. The rest of you guys can go. Okay. I need you guys to get some biology 2 tests.
Alright.
Okay. Yeah. You guys go. Now, this is the key to the office, to the building outside, and to the storeroom.
Alright. Say some hoosh for us, would you?
Now, be careful, Hawk. Leave everything just like it was.
You don't have to worry about a thing.
Alright. Count on you. Hey, buddy. How's it going?
Okay, I guess.
Here's your cut from this week. You'll be happy to know I upped you from 10% to 15%.
Really?
Yeah, now you're gonna have to work on figuring 15% in your head.
I haven't even figured out 10% yet.
Come on, let's go inside.
Stuck. Just break it!
Hey, I gotta get out of here, alright?
Alright. Yeah.
Wanda.
Hi.
Matt, we're not to hang out for his birthday party. I just wanted to tell you that I'm going to be picking you up at 7:30 sharp.
Well, who do you think you are? You don't just tell a girl that she's got a date with you.
But...
forget it. I'm not interested.
Hi, Matt.
Come here, guys.
I thought you told me you guys didn't have any trouble Saturday night.
Yeah, Matt. A clean getaway.
Clean getaway? Well, I just left the principal's office and somebody saw you.
You didn't get close to see who we were.
You stupid idiots! Didn't you realize that when you broke that window that they would check everything? They're going to change every lock in this building. They're going to change every test in this building.
Gee, Matt, we're sorry.
You're sorry? Do you have any idea how long it took me to get those tests? How long it took me to get those keys? Gosh!
Do you think he's got the real coin?
We've got to do something.
Yeah, but Matt's too well organized.
Maybe not.
Well, what do you have in mind?
I don't know. Alone we don't stand the chance, but if we stick together, maybe we can do something about it.
Yeah, it might work, but all we gotta do is prove that Matt's the one responsible.
Yeah. I think I'd like to have everybody over at my house. We'll spread it around to the people that we trust. Everyone meet there around 8.
Okay.
I don't think I'll come.
I'd like to have you there, B.
Hey, I'll come by your house and then we'll walk over together, okay?
Okay.
Alright guys, I've gotta go. Got a committee meeting.
Okay.
See ya.
Hey, Wanda.
What do you want?
You know, you kind of hurt Kirk's feelings when you turn him down.
I don't really care. Besides, he didn't even ask me. He just told me.
Well, if you're not interested in going with Cricket to the party, would you want to go with me?
Is this just a trick, so I'll end up as Cricket's date?
No. I just want you to go with me is all.
What about Lita?
I'll give her to Cricket.
Oh, well, what kind of presents do you like?
Oh, you don't need to bring a gift. Let's just say you'll be my present.
I'm not really interested, and as far as I'm concerned, you're even more repulsive than Cricket is.
Did you have any luck, Matt?
No.
Well, a bunch of kids are going over to Bob's tonight. She might be there. Could you set up then?
Look, will you forget it, will ya?
But if you're such a big man, why can't you set it up like you said you would?
Okay, you got it. Tonight.
Really?
Yeah, come on. Hey, can I give you a lift?
That's not necessary. I'm not going very far.
Come on. I just want to give you a ride. Come on. I'm pretty good. I want to think. Pretty girl going for a bar. Sorry. It's just when I offer a girl a ride, I expect her to accept. That's all. Let's get going, Cricket.
Where to, Matt?
I don't know where you're going, but I'm going to Bob Johnson's.
Let's go someplace quiet, like the Lakewood Park Road.
Oh, it's B. Hey, B. Where's Wanda?
I don't know. I called her, but she won't answer.
Huh.
I probably just missed her.
Yeah, we're gonna start the meeting here in a minute.
Okay.
Alright, we've had a nice little drive. Now, please take me home.
But baby, we just got
get
here.
Get your hands off of me!
Leave her alone, Matt.
Look, you mind your own business, will ya?
But I thought she was supposed to be my girl, Matt.
Yeah, well, I changed my mind.
Yeah, but Matt, you've got Lita.
No, you've got Lita. This is my dish here.
But Matt, you promised.
Look, get out of here, will ya? Can't you see we want to be alone?
Get off of me!
You said,
get out! Get out!
Leave me alone! I said, leave me alone!
Look, how about some mood music?
You've got to listen to me. It's about Kelly. Matt killed Kelly. It's all Matt's fault. Honest, it is. You've got to believe me. Pat, wasn't I with Matt at the races? Didn't I go home with him?
Yeah, that's right. He did want to get that coin back.
We didn't go home. We parked and we waited for Kelly. Matt chased him and he drove him off the road.
If we all stick together, we can get some proof.
Look, I have the coin!
Where is everybody?
I wouldn't know, Matt.
But they're supposed to be here. It's my birthday party.
Is this the police?
Now what did you do this for? Where is everybody? I got a job for you, just like old times. Where is everybody? I didn't need you. I didn't need any of you. I never needed you. You needed me. You can always get along without anybody. Without anybody. Without anybody. Bob? Bob, where is everybody? Okay, Bob, I can explain. It was an accident, okay? I did not mean to, okay? Okay. I was just angry and I wanted to talk to him about the coin, okay? That's all I wanted to do. I was just wanting to talk to him. I did not mean to. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to. That's it. I wanted it back. I really did not mean to, okay? Bob, help me, please. Bob, help me. Please.
I'm going to.
Bob? Cricket? Bob? Cricket! Cricket, explain to him! Tell him it wasn't my fault! You too, Cricket? I'm sorry! I'm sorry! Dad? Dad? Dad.
Hey, scoot over, I made these reservations.
Hey, what picture are we going to see tonight? Mom, let me do that again.
You haven't
laughed
5 times.
Kelly, it's all Matt's fault. Honest, it is. You've got to listen to, you've got to believe me. Pat.
Thanks, Matt, but I can still afford my own. Can we redo that?
No, yeah.
What they're going to do now that you guys broke that window, they're going to change every lock and they're going to check everything. They're going to take.
No, I'm
and somebody saw you.
He didn't get close to see who we were.
And he wouldn't recognize us anyway.
We didn't think it mattered.
Oh, we didn't think it mattered.
Since he didn't recognize
us. Since he didn't recognize us.
And I think maybe you might be able to get me to the bottom. It'd be a lot easier for you to find out just who's this. I believe it is. I'm sorry. Gosh darn it.
Thanks.
No.
Not a very good race.
Just a minute, Stevens. We're doing fine by ourselves. We're not paying an entry fee to you or anybody else.
Yeah!
I'm not paying either.
Well, good luck, Rod.
Anyone a bet it?
Well, good luck, Rod.
You too, man.
Anyone want to bet on a winner?
People crying do not fluff their hair.
No, I do. Hardcore.
That's perfect.
I heard about it.
Pretty funny accident, huh?
Now why do you make the crack like that?
I mean, I heard you.
Okay.
Okay, can you make more noise?
I said, do I need to make noise? I don't know. Okay.
Hey, knock it off, man. I hate you. I hate you. Knock it off, man. Pull over. Knock it off, man.
The whole bag. The money goes in the bag. And then the bag goes to Wanda. It's a drawstring. There you go. Okay, man's line. All go.
Hey, what the heck are you doing? This is private property.
Okay, hey, Ben. You're the one who walked up to it, so you wouldn't say that.
How's the president this morning?
Pretty good, babe.
Hey, Matt.
Hey, B. Where's Wanda?
I tried calling her, but she wouldn't answer.
Huh. I probably just missed her.
Yeah.
I did miss her. You said
Bob, I swear, it was just an accident. Are you gonna hit me this time?
No. I didn't know.
I was just wanting to talk to him about the coin. That's it. I did not mean to do it, okay? When does he hit me?
Not yet.